Hey everyone, hope you're having a good day. My name's Andy. My channel is Finding Value. Today we're going to do our daily technical analysis updating commodities, work our way through the dollar yields, precious metals, and commodities ETFs that I follow. I'll interject my financial opinions as we go through it. And if you need help with anything, check out finding-value.com where I dive deeper into all of these sectors looking for potential investment opportunities. We still have May Day coupon code that's active if you're interested. 50% off only the first month on a monthly membership and a larger discount on the yearly membership if you're interested. All right, so let's dive in here. Let's take a look and see what's going on today. We've got a weaker dollar down about 0.3%. It's been moving back and forth. We could see this break to the downside with today's price action. It is a bearish engulfing. We also have one here. So yields were jumping up a little bit and looks like they reversed throughout the day. That's why you get that big wick at the top there that we've got going on. And this could break through that support line and go on lower. So that's what we have to watch for. If it does that, we'll see a lower dollar. And that's generally driven by yields. So let's go see what yields look like and if that matches it. The two-year yield, we are down 0.86% today. It is a bearish engulfing. It's not a very big one. And the momentum is still downward. So the momentum's there. And we have a little bit of a bearish engulfing. We'll see if we get follow through tomorrow or the next trading days. The 10-year yield's up a little bit. We do have a wick at the top, signifying a little bit of selling pressure. It's kind of a tougher read here. It's not, doesn't have all the momentum in the world going down. We've come on up a little bit, but I would see or look for a potential candlestick that could show us that maybe we could potentially head lower. That would be a bearish engulfing or some bearish candlestick that's next. And I'm only using that because of the wick that I see today of the trading reversal. So if you were to look at this, you see a reversal trending lower. Is what I'm seeing in the candlestick. 30-year yield also up 0.8%. We do have a little wick at the top, and we'll see what this looks like. We've got a battle between the sellers and the buyers. I would say it's favoring the sellers a little bit as the momentum is already established to the downside. We've come on up, and we do have a little wick at the top, and we could potentially roll over here to the downside in the short term. We'll have to see how much selling pressure there is, or how much downside yield pressure is how I should say it. We'll have to see what that looks like in the next candlestick. TYX, TNX ratio, it is up a little bit. And again, we're coming from a low level to a much higher level, which is supportive of higher gold, silver, and precious metals pricing. That's that yield curve on inverting. That is exactly what we're looking at. Bond prices, which go counter to yields, down a little bit today. And then we've been chopping as we've gone up in an uptrend. I still think the momentum's to the upside. That hasn't reversed yet, but we very well could reverse it at any time. We'd have to wait and see. But right now, that's to the upside. 2 and 10, this is the yield curve. It is uninverting. We had the two-year down 0.86%, and we had the 10-year up 0.35%. So it's a pretty good move to the downside of the yield curve on inverting or normalizing. They also call it steepening. So slowdowns generally occur in this corridor of where we are heading, which is on the bigger picture move as we come down. That is when things generally occur. It's somewhere in this range that we are heading towards. Does that mean that something catastrophic is coming? I don't know. That we don't know. Gold up, likes that yield curve on inverting, and the dollar weakening. So we have a bullish engulfing here. We'll see if we can get some upside momentum to break through this little rising wedge that we've got ourselves in. Silver also up 1.5%, big bullish engulfing, sitting on top of support. This looks pretty bullish, guys. This looks awfully bullish here for a move higher, and it could be rapid. It could be rapid. So general rule of thumb is, okay, so this pattern here, this guy here, that's the same pattern as what we've seen here. It's the same pattern of coming up and what that looks like there. This is that. So this here is this here. It's the same pattern, and I think we are ready to activate full-on bull mode. You can also state that this pattern here is this pattern here. So it's the same rough general shape for silver. So let's just use this as the bull, the big bull pattern here. I'm going to go a little bit ballistic, Goose. Yep. I'm talking about Top Gun, if you didn't notice. So this is that pattern there. Do you guys see it? And this here very well could go to some ridiculous level. I'm just throwing it over there. It's not perfect. Something like that. And maybe we get to $100 or something. I don't know. That's what the bigger pattern is. So we've got a pattern within a pattern in silver. And then this is also going to activate the other pattern. This just keeps getting better, guys, doesn't it? That will activate this big pattern here, which then could throw us up to this level way up there. So it's a pattern within a pattern within a pattern. First pattern one, pattern two, and then pattern three. You guys got it? You guys got it. Platinum also has that same pattern. If I were to, I don't know if I saved that pattern. One second, guys. Let me go back and save it. Well, I can recreate it real quick. So the pattern I'm talking about is this guy here. It's this little jumble pattern, which is the same as that one. Save it. Platinum. So we go to platinum. And what I see is a faint, very faint resemblance of the, that is the same pattern there, guys. So this is just jumbled up. It is squeezing up, and that's where we're located as we're trying to come out of that pattern there. It's just flattened and squeezed up in the corner there. It's the same pattern, though. And this thing's ready to launch at any second, too. We were up 1.5% today. That also is a bullish engulfing today on a flag pattern, looking ready to meander its way higher. And that's also sitting on top of a falling wedge. Correct. Palladium, 1.78, looking pretty good today. We do have a big bearish engulfing yesterday, and that could work its way into a consolidation of some sort. It's possible. And this is the metal that kind of goes counter to the others, but it looks good still on a longer-term basis. Momentum to the upside. GDX up 1.7% today. We've got GDXJ up and SILJ up. They all have something very similar. That similarity, we'll just look at GDXJ, is that we are trading sideways for the most part. That's a consolidation or a move higher in all of them. It's all the same pattern. So that looks really good. And GDX is the furthest along, with SILJ being the laggard of the group, which makes sense. XAU to gold ratio up a teeny bit today, up 0.18%. We are still in a little bit of a consolidation. I'll just draw that on top there. We've been bouncing back and forth here, and eventually we will break, most likely, where gold and silver mining companies will outperform gold, and we will all be happy because we own the mining companies already from a stupid low price down here, and it will work its way on up, outperforming gold. And I think gold will go higher. Crude oil up 1.7% today. It is a bullish engulfing right there. Now, a lot of the recession boys, they're screaming, you know, they're crying wolf here that we've got a recession for sure. And that might be the case. I don't know. But this is a bullish engulfing, and that generally works its way on up. It is a reversal candlestick where the sellers tried to sell it off, but they failed. This is what it looks like from a I'll get in here a little bit more. This is what it looks like on a short-term basis. Basically, we've got a downtrend line that's broken. There we go. We pulled on up. They tried selling it back off, but we created a higher low. In a trend reversal on a downtrend, the first one is a low. a break of the downtrend, then you come on up to this point here. You create a higher low, which is here, and we are positioned. You can see the big buying and small selling pressure coming up to break this 71.45 area. If we break that, we are now in a new short-term uptrend. That is Trader Vic bottom, if you want to look. That's the technicals there. Now, if we break through that, that could maybe propel us back into the pattern and get us out of the pattern. This would then be a false breakdown, potentially. We're not there yet. We got some work to do, but the momentum's to the upside. TTF gas down 6%. Ooh, look at that. Look at that sharp reversal day. That does look like we could go lower. That is a bearish engulfing. We have another one here. We came all the way into the corner here, tried breaking out, and got rejected at that resistance line. We'll see what the follow-through looks like. Natural gas in America doing the exact opposite, putting in a nice bounce off support, big bullish engulfing. Well, it's almost a bullish engulfing candlestick. It looks good. It's a hammer candlestick too. You can grab the stick of it there and start hammering away. But that looks really good to maybe move higher for nat gas. XOP, yeah, you know me, up 1.6%. Not the most confidence-inspiring candlestick there, but it is working its way on up. Now, are we going to recapture that uptrend line that we lost? I don't know. We'll have to wait and see. We'll have to see if we can get up there and break through it. That's what we're watching. And I think it'll be highly dependent on what oil does, obviously. OIH having a pretty strong day. Not a great candlestick, though. It was up 2.5%. And again, we'll have to see if we get that momentum to the upside. Right now, this does look a little bit ugly coming back down here in how short of a time frame that this has fallen. We'll have to see if it comes up and then reverses and rolls back over, which is still a possibility if we get a slowdown in the market. And I'm tying this into that yield curve that we talked about earlier, the 2 and 10. Newcastle coal futures, which is another energy area, up 1.11% today. And I still think that this is going to go sideways or work its way on up eventually. We've got Sprott Physical Uranium Trust breaking to the upside. Let's see if we can hold. It's not a confidence-inspiring candlestick. I want to see a big green boy show up like you know, this guy there and get us out of here. I want to see the buyers be like, look, we're in control here. Stop dicking around with the sellers here. Let's get going, right? But it's a good start. We're not playing with the downside breakup. We're playing with an upside breakup. Futures pricing remaining sideways. No movement there. We're in that dead period where the buyers equal the sellers. URA showing some good strength, 3.65% today. It's looking better, and it could be a double bottom with that guy going across, and maybe we can break on out. We've got URNM also doing the same thing. It's a double bottom going across, and we could be working our way on up, and hopefully that's the case. URNJ is doing the same exact thing here, guys. Same exact thing, same exact setup. Nice little flag pattern that we've broken to the upside. It looks good. Doing well. It's doing well. Copper up 1.12%. Still looks good to work its way on up. It's just doing it nice and slow. COPX blazing today, up 3.6%, breaking above its trend line. We could see a return move and a retest here. Don't get discouraged. That would be a buying opportunity at $42. Iron ore up 1.77, looking good, feeling good. Says, what's his name? Something Murphy, the actor. But that looks really good. Or a move on up. Could be a little bit of a double bottom here. We just got to break it. Aluminum up 0.71%. It is still chopping sideways between the resistance support areas. We've got nickel down 0.95%. It doesn't look horrible, but it's hanging in there. It's hanging in there. We've got Moo. Moo up 1.85. Looking good, Moo. God, look at that Moo there. So that looks really, really good. The thing that makes me more bullish on this is that it's creating a new high. That's what we created today. So that is what gives me a little bit more confidence and oomph that this has some staying momentum moving to the upside, some staying power is what I'll call it. Emerging markets up 2.12, likes the weaker dollar. And we've broken this downtrend there, so that looks good. Hopefully it can keep going up. But we've got KRE up 2.83%, likes the weaker dollar. Potentially yields, depending on what yield you're looking at. But that's looking good. TAN down 0.75%. That's an ugly looking candlestick. What the heck? I'm not in TAN, but we're above support. We'll see if it holds. We've got lithium up 2.23 right underneath this. If this breaks here, guys, we could see some potential investment opportunities in lithium. REMX also up 3.5%. I think if we can break through this area here, it'd give me a little bit more confidence that we could be putting in a bottom. We got Baltic Dry Index down slightly, but still above support. Still looking good. XHB, oh my God. Reventure Consulting, is this the middle finger that we've got generated here for XHB for him? Crash boys, what happened? I thought housing was going to go down. Why are the home builders up 2.75% today? I don't know, guys. This looks pretty strong. Doesn't look like it's coming back. This is the driver of what is a blow-off top. And I'm not saying that this is going to be the end. What I'm saying is that this could be something that has a lot of legs left, like this, or something on the lines of that. Something that does this. Some big move is what I think is coming. Russell 2000, that's what the yield's dropping. Russell 2000 up 2.1%. It's following the home builders higher. So that's good. We're up against a little bit of resistance there. We'll see if we can break it. SPX going up. Is this going to be a throwover false breakout, or is this going to continue higher, or are we going to get a retest and a move higher? I don't know yet. I wouldn't get too ballsy on it. It does have that type of pattern that sometimes you see break, but we'll see where it goes. NASDAQ's got the same thing. It's got that same pattern. Everything's financialized, but it's got a breakout today. We'll see if we get a retest and a break higher, or if it just continues on up. And if we can't hold this line here and breaks back down, it was a falsy. SMCI moving sideways. Still looking like crap. We've got NVIDIA up 4%. This could be that same pattern that we could get before a big move higher. If it still has one last breath of air in it, is what we'll call it. BTC ripping. This still looks good, though. It's a pattern that's facing downward that could easily break to the upside. And then we've got Ethereum also up 3.85%, still within the pattern. Which is a downward-facing pattern like this, it looks good. It could easily work its way on up here, breaking that downtrend there. That looks all right. So that's what I've got for today, guys. Give me a thumb up for the content. Subscribe to the channel. Subscribe to the website. If you guys want to know how to play this bull market in commodities coming up, sign up. Got May Day coupon code. Give you a little bit of a discount. Try it out. Join the community. We've got a question and answer session coming up at 5 p.m. on Sunday. 5 p.m. Sunday. Ask me whatever you want. We can go over whatever you guys want. We can go over oil. We can go over precious metals, mining companies. I did that last time. And if you guys are interested in signing up, you can check the last one I have posted. We went over a lot of the precious metals equities and what I think are good setups. I mean, yes, I use a lot of technical analysis like you see here. We can go over other sectors too, like tankers, dry bulk shipping, diversified mining companies, steel companies. There's a whole bunch of opportunities out there, emerging markets, anything you guys want. I have my favorites. I've combed through a lot. I think I'm in what I would consider to be some of the most explosive upside potential companies in precious metals, in oil, in all the sectors. And that's basically my entire portfolios, maximizing risk-reward basis. And then if you were to make it an equation, I multiply it by the probability of success, which takes a little bit of experience to figure out what works more often than not versus other ones that may not work as often. But that's what I've got for today. We'll catch you next time. This is Finding Value.